Hi, I'm Frank Shankless, probably best known as the creator and a founder of the Make-A-Wish Foundation, and I do it the easy way.
Hi, my name's Andrew Steele. I'm playing the incredible Frank Shankwitz in his biopic, Wishman, and I'm the president and founder of Flicks for Change, the film festival with a social conscience, and I do it the easy way.
Hey guys, it's Eric Easy Zuli here for EasyWay.tv, Women's Broadcast Television Network, Voice America, and yes, we are with the great Frank Shankwitz, and we're just, this is really cool. So before I introduce them, I want to talk a little bit. I've interviewed over 2,500 celebrities in my lifetime. And I think this is going to be number one because what I'm about to tell you guys. This is an exclusive beyond an exclusive. This is so cool. So I didn't even know this and I was watching on stage. So we're here with the creator and the co-founder of the Make-A-Wish Foundation, Frank Shankwitz.
And happy to be here. And you got to be great because you got me putting something on top.
I know. I snuck that in. You like that product? We're on the board together, and we're both making a difference. Right. So, and that's what EasyWay is about. And then we're with Andrew Steele. But check this out. This is incredible. Andrew, you are playing Frank Shankwitz in the new movie, the new Hollywood movie. And you're Andrew. That's so cool.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible. I really feel like Wayne's World here. I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy. So, you know, what a role. He's done so many incredible things, 415,000 wishes to date, which is just amazing. And I'm so humbled to be, you know, actually Frank's choice to play him. So I really appreciate that.
So, Frank, why do you think you chose Andrew out of everybody? I mean, I'm sure the casting was huge.
Well, we had met at an event in either Beverly Hills or Hollywood. I can't remember which. And we just started talking. And I'm just looking at his personality. But the biggest thing was, I said, try on my cowboy hat. So
oh, there goes these. Okay.
And I said, okay. This is the guy that's going to play me in my mid-30s.
That's all it takes. So there's the secret sauce. There's the official secret sauce from Frank Shankwitz on how to get hired for a film. Look good in a cowboy hat.
That's right. That's right.
That's a good quote. Yeah.
And you have a song. You have a special song that's called Make a Wish or...
Wishman.
Wishman, yeah. Okay. And can you sing the hook for us? You know, sure. It was awesome. I'll sing it.
Wishman, I write this song. You're gonna be the wishman, make a wishman. Yeah, you be the wishman. Just think of the kids, man. Thousands of kids and their happy families. All thanks to the wishman. You're gonna be the wishman. Yeah, you be the wishman. Just think of the kids, man. Thousands of kids and their happy families.
Give back, little Frank, show your daddy you're a man. Tell your mama that you love her too. Though she left you in the cold, it's not really her fault. Hear the words I wanna sing to you. You're gonna be the wish man, make a wish man. Yeah, you'll be the wish man. Just think of the kids, man, thousands of kids, man. All getting to live their dreams because you're the wish man. You're gonna be the wish man. Yeah, you'll be the wish man. Just think of the kids, man. Thousands of kids, man. Yeah, you are the wish man.
He's blown up, isn't he?
I love it. Okay, Frank, it's your turn.
Okay. let me see. I always wanted to be a cowboy.
There you go. I love it. Well, you know, I feel honored to be doing this interview, and I know everybody out there. I mean, we have a lot of viewers when we really push this out, and well, the viewers we have are influencers, and our objective is to influence the influencers, to influence their following, to make a difference. And your story is so inspiring, Frank, and I know that you just got done doing it for a long time on stage, but on the short version, can you tell us how the whole Make-A-Wish thing got started?
Wow, the short version. In 1980, I was a motorcycle officer with Arizona Highway Patrol. And the patrol was informed about a 7-year-old boy named Chris who had terminal leukemia. And his heroes were from a popular television show at the time called Chips, which was an adventure about two California Highway Patrol motorcycle officers. And he told his mom, I wish when I grow up I could be a motorcycle officer, like the characters Punch and John from this TV show. His parents contacted our department, asked if there was any way he could meet a motorcycle officer. Our department went beyond that. They set up a special day for Chris with permission of his mother and doctor, picked him up at his hospital. He's on IVs, and flew him to our headquarters building, and they asked me to be standing by because I have been working with children all over the state. because I was on a squad that worked the whole state of Arizona. And when this little boy landed, I expected the paramedics to help him out. I had never met this little boy. Little pair of red sneakers jumps out of the helicopter, runs over to me, "Hi, I'm Chris, can I get on your motorcycle?" He is just beaming and laughing, a typical seven-year-old. And I'm looking at his mother and she's crying. And it dawned on me, because she has her seven-year-old back. And his wish is becoming true. But just the condensed version, we went on that day to make Chris the only honorary motorcycle officer in the history of the Arizona Highway Patrol. This is 37 years ago. Complete with what we ended up doing, a custom-made uniform for him, his own badge, his own smoky helmet, everything that it could need to be a police officer. But he says, "How do I be a motorcycle officer? I wish I could be a motorcycle officer." So we're just teasing him, and we found out he had a little battery-operated motorcycle that his mother got for him in place of a wheelchair. We set up traffic cones. He went through it. "Did I pass?" "Yes, you did, Chris." "When do I get my wings?" That was so important to him. It took a couple days to get the wings. I get a call from the hospital. Chris is in a coma. He's not going to survive the day. Just as I got at the hospital and pinged wings on his uniform, Chris comes out of the coma. He looks at me, "Am I a motorcycle officer now?" "Yes, you are, Chris." His wish had become true. He died a couple hours later. But we learned he was going to be buried in a little town called Kewaunee, Illinois, so my commander asked if I would go back and give him a full police funeral, which we did. He was buried in uniform. His grave marker reads, "Chris Gracious, Arizona Trooper." But coming home, I just started thinking about this boy. He had a wish, and we made it happen. Why can't we do that for other children? And that's when the idea was born, and now 37 years later, as Andrew said, over 415,000 wishes have been granted, all because of this one little boy.
Wow, the legacy lives on. I can just imagine the parents and the family of that. I mean, that was the originator. Everybody else, there was a domino effect.
Right, and it's so fun at this conference today that I met a wish child that has survived. About 70% of the children are surviving now. And her wish was a Disney cruise. And I always ask them when I meet them, "What was your wish?" And I just watch their eyes because they light up. They're reliving that whole thing, even though
it was awesome
7 years ago. So, yeah.
You know, I feel you 100% because I told you in this last interview with Actors Reporter, there was a little girl, and I'm not going to do the whole long story, but little girl, her lifelong dream was to meet the Blue Ranger on Nickelodeon's Power Rangers, Super Samurai. And they tried over and over and over again to try to get a hold of the Power Rangers, the representation, all that stuff. And they contacted me from a YouTube video, and they said, "Hey, our little daughter, she's 4 years old, out of Canada. She's always wanted to meet Najee. I saw you did an interview with Najee. Can you do anything?" I was so touched by that message. I connected her to Najee on my radio show, and on top of that, and we had this big old ordeal. I haven't even put this out yet. It's not out yet. This is an idea I had, and I told you, you're my inspiration for this. It's like a Make-A-Wish type of show, and you literally see a little four-year-old girl, and her eyes light up like nobody's business. When Najee Detez, the Blue Ranger, walks in, he came with like bags of Power Ranger stuff and just crazy stuff, and she was in a little Power Ranger outfit,
yeah,
like a little cute outfit and stuff. So it's amazing to make people's wish dreams come true. And
It is, and it takes so many people to do it, obviously worldwide. People say, "Look what you did." Well, no, well, I had an idea and made it work, but it took millions of people to make this work and continue to make it work. And I'm just so grateful for that this legacy lives on.
Well, we're both on the board of the Speakers Coalition, and it's an amazing organization. How did you meet Allison? Why did you decide to join the board?
She asked me. And actually, this is the first time I met her in person, because the first time I was supposed to, she contacted me via Facebook. And I was supposed to speak at an event in March, and that's when I had this accident. I had a compound fracture, and I was supposed to talk to you at the same time.
Yeah, we've been trying back and forth.
Yeah, so, but I really want to help what I can with the speakers, whatever we can to get more speakers out, to get the message out, whatever it might be.
Well, so let's go back into the movie, because I'm excited about this. Like, let's talk about this. So it's shooting in August, right? Yes?
Arizona, in Frank's hometown.
Oh, up in the mountains of Arizona, Prescott, Arizona.
Awesome. And Voice America, that's their hometown. In fact, we have a lot of people in Arizona. So Digital handshake, come talk to Frank. So tell us about what the story plot line is, anything in particular that we can be excited for?
Well, it's really Frank's life. I mean, there's a few tweaks. Hollywood's got its hands in there to make it, you know.
It's based on a true story. Now, when you go to the movie theater and you see based on a true story, it's not the true story. Mm-hmm. Hollywood embellished the heck out of it. But we finally got script approval. I've got script approval on there, and we finally got, okay, I agree to the screenplay and that. But what I want to compliment Andrew on is, first of all, getting rid of the Aussie accent. Now, he forgets that I go to bed kind of early, about midnight. At 2 in the morning, he's calling me, Frank, listen to this.
He's always on Facebook. What are you talking about, mate? I can always see you're active. He's a bit of a night owl.
But working with the dialogue coach, because
yeah, you are always on Facebook, but yeah, you never share my stuff. You never like my stuff. What's up with that?
I do.
I'm just kidding.
But the big thing also is he's went through motorcycle training because he has to play a motorcycle officer, and now we're going to get him going through weapons training.
You're going to go through a process to be
there. Oh, yeah. Just look at all the work that they have to do to handle this role. And I'm technical advisor on the film, so I'm going to beat the heck out of him. If he does something wrong, he's going to know about it.
Oh, yeah. I bet you're looking forward to that.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, definitely working on the accent. And, you know, from, you know, Seligman, Arizona, it's a different sound there. It's not quite a drawl. It's definitely more, earthy kind of tone. I'm so excited to play Frank and, try and do justice to this great man.
We had him and the executive director came up several months ago, and we're in a van going up to Seligman, Arizona, about 70 miles from where we look at locations up there. And there's this voice in the back, and I'm thinking, did somebody record my voice? And it's him messing around with me because I'm driving, and he sounds just like me in there. And I thought, wow, this guy's really working.
Well, it sounds really exciting, and I'm assuming, is there distribution, theatrical release, or is that just, it's mainly in production?
We've got worldwide distribution already. The contracts are signed. What's so nice is the Arizona governor, I got a call from his office 2 days ago. The governor's office, the Arizona Bureau of Tourism, the Arizona Film Industry are going to feature this film as the film being made in Arizona that's going to go worldwide on advertising. We could never afford something like that. So it's just great that it's going to feature everything that we're doing and hopefully get more films in Arizona again.
Well, awesome. And now you have Easy Way supporting you. And we have a platform that's kind of like YouTube. It's called Easy Way Tube. So it's YouTube the Easy Way. And I'd love to get your channel on there, and we'll push it out to as many people as we can and do some teasers and really get the word out. I'm sure that everybody's excited to see the movie, right? Like, I know I'm excited. And if you happen to have a role for a reporter that's a white guy looking real nice and he's a good networker, let me know, you know? I mean, but guys, yeah, sure.
Call out. The way I met Frank was actually, I run a non-profit film festival called Flicks for Change, and the story I like to think is why I got the role is because I'm running this non-profit film festival. It's called Flicks for Change. You can check it out on online, FLICKS, the digit for change.org. It's a film festival with a social conscience. So it's in November this year, 12th to the 15th of November in downtown LA at a great place called Boomtown Brewery. And it's a film festival with a social conscience. So we have open panel discussions with heads of nonprofits and charity organizations, live music, virtual reality films, a whole bunch of stuff. Like, packing 1,000 people in each night. So we'd love people to come down, submit films, and get involved with the discussion, because it's what we can do together and bring in all these different organizations that we can really raise a platform for our voices to be heard and for incredible things like the Make-A-Wish to bubble up and, you know, make a change in the world.
Yeah, well, great. Well, definitely we'll support that. What did you guys think of our Easy Way panel today? Did you enjoy that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was fun. Yeah, it was fun. And while we're doing plugs...
Yeah. There is a book.
We're scheduled...
Cha-ching, cha-ching.
Yeah, we're scheduled for the premiere of the movie in Cannes in May of 2018.
Awesome.
We're really excited about that. Cannes read the screenplay, the board, and they haven't even seen the finished product, and so we want to premiere this movie there.
You know,
so
Frank,
an honor to me.
We did a project, and I'm just throwing this out there. We did something with a film and the fact that you go around the world or whatever, but we offered an opportunity for somebody out there, whoever helped share the project the most would get an opportunity to come along with being on set and things like that, and it worked out incredibly. Like, people, they went viral with it because they wanted that opportunity. You think there'd be a chance to do something like that for the fans?
We're talking with the executive producer on that, because they obviously on a set they don't want all the interference in that, so they're only allowing a limited amount of people. But we're trying to figure out how we're gonna choose those type people. So we're still working on that, and that's up to him. That's not up to me.
I tried, guys. I tried.
Yeah. Yeah, but I think it's definitely a possibility.
It worked great.
Figure it out, and we'll let you know if you can come on set.
Exactly. Well, you guys are awesome, and this is a great interview. I really appreciate it. And my 2501. And, and this is awesome. And that's yours. You guys can keep those Easy Way hats.
Nobody ever seen it.
Oh my gosh, that's huge right there. You see that? No, they directly wore the hat. Thank you, Frank. I appreciate it, man. I'm looking forward to making a difference with you. And thank you, Andrew. You guys are awesome. Get a shot, everybody. Click, 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 click. Easy Way. Love you guys. So, hey, guys, if you want to connect with Frank, you want to connect with Andrew, we do the digital handshake. Remember, if you text Easy Way, letter E, letter Z, W-A-Y, to the number 21777, we will do the best we can to get you connected to our influencers here. We're having a blast. So today's interview and the Spirit Summit and everything with EasyWay.tv is brought to you by Hilo, ericzuli.com/Hilo.
Introducing Hilo, the world's first health and lifestyle oracle, a real-time health monitoring device unlike any other wearable device on the planet. Hilo can monitor the most important measurements, including heart rate, blood pressure, breath rate, daily steps, calories burned, and Hilo can even perform an EKG. Hilo can also sense your mood, if you're excited or even if you're fatigued. Paired with the latest smartphone application, you can now track the health and well-being of your loved ones. Imagine being able to monitor your aging parents even if you're thousands of miles away, or getting an alert if your spouse's blood pressure is too high. Hilo not only monitors your important measurements, but it produces a daily, weekly, and monthly health report that you can provide to your trainer or physician. In the near future, Hilo will be able to monitor blood sugar levels, alcohol levels in our blood, oxygen levels, temperature, and even keep disease-delivering mosquitoes away. But Hilo is more than the world's most advanced health monitoring device. Hilo can also alert you if your loved ones are in danger. Unfortunately, more and more women and children go missing each day, according to the FBI. With Hilo, a child walking home from school can now press the panic button twice, and his or her Hilo guardians can be sent an emergency alert via text, notifying their guardians that they need help. And what's amazing is that the guardians will get the exact GPS location of their loved one. Let's take a look at another scenario. What if you're taking a walk around your neighborhood and you sense danger lurking? Having that peace of mind to simply alert your loved ones can be a lifesaver. Now that you've seen the power of this revolutionary product, I'm positive you're ready to order one for you and your family members. However, Hilo is not found in stores. Hilo can only be purchased online. So click on the Buy It Now link or fill out our form to get more information about the Hilo right now.
Is brought to you by Hilo, ericzuli.com/Hilo. It's the best digital health game changer in the planet. And I mean, seriously, like you can, I'm not going to go into everything. You can go to the website and see what's up. And I'd love for you guys to check it out. Love the interview.
I don't have mine on. It's charging right now.
No, you're with Eric Swanson and that, his group and everything.
Gave me one. It does work fantastic. Yeah, it's just charging right now. So that's why I'm not.
Well, now that I'm sponsored by AZY, I'll expect that in the mail anytime.
Exactly. Yeah, I love it. That's how magical we are. We say the word Easy Way and you get free awesome gear that helps to monitor your health. I love it. So thanks guys. I'm Eric Zulli for EasyWay.tv, Women's Broadcast Television Network, Voice America, Fan TV, Amazon, Wascal, Frontier, Verizon. It goes on and on. And this has been amazing. I learned a lot. Hope you guys did too. And stay tuned because we're going to be doing some digital stuff together. We're going to be doing some Easy Way Care stuff together. It's going to be amazing. So thank you so much, guys. Keep doing it the Easy Way. Hashtag Easy Way Fam because you guys are family. You're not fans. And we'll be back at the next one. See you later.
Bye. So long.